keep anything over $5. Does all that else we donate?
Good morning.
Can I do all $176? How much? Yeah, it never fucking set. I can't restock. Oh. Expensive. Here I go, rob some people. So, which one's the image? This is me. All right, let's go see John.
Hey, Arthur.
What do you want?
Uncle told me something about a train.
What did he say?
Mary Beth overheard something about a train full of wealthy folk rolling down through Scarlet Meadows just south of the state border.
Yes.
Need help with it?
I ain't even sure about doing it.
Come on. At night, not too guarded, it's perfect.
Nah, I ain't thought it through. You know, stopping a train, pain in the ass.
Sure. But what if we could force a train to stop?
Well, of course.
We get a wagon full of something flammable, oil. Put it on the tracks. They see it. They know they either have to stop or die. Ain't no train driver wants to be cooked alive.
That is kind of brilliant. For you. That is a real idea. I think that's the first time you ever had one of them.
Shut up.
You might be the first bastard to ever have half his brains eaten by a wolf and end up more intelligent.
So we're doing it?
Yeah, we're gonna need ammunition, guns, look real frightening, and some dynamite to open up the train.
I'll get the supplies. Gotta head into town for Abigail anyway. Don't even ask. You go find us an oil wagon.
Yeah, I know just the place. They're always heading into that refinery.
There's an old rundown shack just over the border, north of a place called Dewberry Creek. Leave it hidden somewhere near there.
steal some shit for that bastard. God damn it.
How about we take a little walk later? Just you and me.
Oh. What is this? Chuckles. I wanna go hunting. I suck at it.
Come on, girl.
Two things. Let's go try to steal some shit. This one.
Ain't you got somewhere to be?
This one is so fucking hard.
Oh, I'm warning you. I ain't.
I'm running away, running away, running away. Where's my flipping axe? Okay, first you need to get off. Because I don't want you to die. Passing it?
Take this!
Nice. Nice.
Yep.
Nice. Nice. I'm going for my first place. Run, Cedric, run. Cedric, catch up. Cedric, safely. Cedric, come on. Cedric left. There we go.
Yep.
Come on. Seriously, I have to set a waypoint? It's not just gonna tell me? Seriously? That's where it wants me to go. I don't understand why it's just a line.
Yours or
I can't even see what it is. Well, then it's probably not mine. Nope. should have moved around here. Nope.
Dumbass.
Never drinking yeah, again, you know. Until later today.
What did I want? You wanted money.
Just a little. Just
poor.
A little.
You already owe me a lot.
I am not well.
Just in time, Mr. Morgan.
I need...
If you are dying, how do you plan to repay me?
Hey, if you could give me some leather working tools, I can make some rugs and blankets and the like out of these hides you're bringing in.
All right, I'll see what I can do. I reckon I'm gonna think about it.
No, no more damage. Just luxury. I just want to be in his way again. Oh no, let's go rob some.
You busy, Arthur?
John?
Let's get on.
Good. And you?
Got everything we need.
Good. I think we need another man. Charles?
I'll go get him. Meet us at the wagon when you can.
Sure.
See, Arthur? Ain't that dumb.
Next time, let the wolves eat all your brain. Then you'll be a genius.
Piper, don't look. Did I seriously just ride all the way here? Good girl. Just to have to ride all the way back. What does it say? Here it is. Well, I guess we'll do. Let's close that one first. Oh. Sorry, John.
Hi, Arthur. Come here a minute.
What is it?
Can I ask you a favor?
Probably not. Scripts.
Very funny. Would you do something with Jack? He seems kind of down. All this upheaval can't have been easy on the poor kid.
Why? Because I'm your preferred nursemaid?
Because he likes you and, well, you know his father's useless.
Okay.
Thank you.
What the fuck is this?
What you up to?
Playing.
Anything fun?
I guess.
You wanna come fishing with me?
Fishing?
Sure. You're right. It's about time that you started to earn your cape.
Okay.
Good. Let's go get your pole then. Now, you do have a fishing pole, don't you?
I sure do. Uncle Jose made me one.
Oh. Good. Well, let's go get it then. Go catch us some fish.
Yeah.
Well, that was kind of everything.
Kid no more. Well, your mama might disagree. Her and a few other women, I guess.
What do you mean?
I'm just talking silly. It's been a tough few weeks up in that snow.
I like the snow.
Yes, but not like that.
When are we going back to the other camp?
The one near Blackwater?
Yeah.
Well, we're not. This is our spot. For now, anyway. Why?
I forgot a storybook there. We left so quick.
All right. This looks as good a spot as any.
Where should we stand, Uncle Arthur?
Down by the shore. Come on, follow me.
I'm so glad we're doing this where I have a mountain.
You can't fish without a pole.
I'm working on it.
First, we need some bait. I'm gonna use some cheese.
Cheese?
Smellier the better. Now, cast your line. Swing the rod back over your shoulder and bring it forward in a smooth motion. Use your wrist, not your elbow.
Like that?
That's it. Good. All we do now, Jack, is wait for a fish to take the bait.
How do I know when I've got a bite?
Well, if you feel the tip of your fishing rod just twitching, don't yank it yet. That just means one's nibbling. If you feel a hard tug, that's a fish going for the bait, so yank hard to hook it.
This is a great fishing spot.
Don't jinx it, kid.
I think you've got a bite. Look!
Whoop, think I got one.
I see. I see.
See him fighting there, Jack? That's when you gotta be careful. You'll break the line. Best to wear him out first before you try to reel him in.
Yeah.
Look, Jack, it's a bluegill. It's almost as small as you. We should really throw these smaller ones back. Give him a chance to grow up a bit.
Can I take a break from fishing? I want to make something.
Okay.
I'm gonna pick some of those red flowers. I'll be right back.
Paper. I'll smell it first.
Right. See what's biting there. See that cast, Jack?
Oh, I'm not supposed to check out here.
Well, let's try again. You gotta stick at things, Jack.
I know. Fishing sure is boring, Uncle Arthur.
I know. Boring as hell. But then, something happens. And you can get food for days.
Really?
If you're lucky. But until then, you just sit, wait, try not to worry. It's good for you.
It's good for you?
I guess.
Huh. You've got a bite, Uncle Arthur?
Got one, Jack.
Is it a big one?
Well, seems like he's taking a rest now. I'm gonna try reeling him in nice and steady. What are you making there?
You'll see. It's a surprise.
This one's a chain picker. Not bad.
Hey, look at this.
And what?
This necklace I made.
Necklace?
For Mama.
Sure.
What a fine young man. And in such complex circumstances. Arthur, isn't it? Arthur Morgan?
Who are you?
Yes, Arthur Morgan. Vanderlyn's most trusted associate. You've read the files. Typical case. Orphaned street kid seduced by that maniac's silver tongue and matures into a degenerate murderer. Agent Milton? Agent Ross, Pinkerton Detective Agency, seconded to the United States government. Nice to finally meet. We know a lot about you.
Do you?
You're a wanted man, Mr. Morgan. It's $5,000 for your head alone.
$5,000? For me? Can I turn myself in?
We want Vanderlyn.
Old Dutch. I haven't seen him for months.
That's so. Because I heard a guy fitting his description robbed a train belonging to Leviticus Cornwall up near Granite Pass.
Oh, ain't that a little old-fashioned nowadays?
Apparently not. Listen. This is my offer, Mr. Morgan. Bring in Vanderlyn, and you have my word you won't swing.
Oh, I ain't gonna swing anyways, Agent,
Milton.
You see, I haven't done anything wrong, aside from not playing the games to your rules.
Spare me the philosophy lesson. I've already heard it from Mac Callender.
Mac Callender?
He was pretty shot up by the time I got to him. So really, it was more of a mercy killing. Slow, but merciful.
You enjoy being a rich man's toy, dear.
I enjoy society, flaws and all. You people venerate savagery, and you will die. Savagely, all of you.
Oh, we're all gonna die, Agent.
Some of us sooner than others. Good day, Mr. Morgan.
Goodbye.
Enjoy your fishing, kid, while you still can.
Who are they?
No one to worry about, no one at all. Come on, let's pick up your things and get home. It's getting late, Jack. Your mother would be worried. Let's head back.
Uncle Dutch is.
Because, well, because those are disagreeable men, and I don't want them to hurt him.
What did they mean about Mac? Is he in jail?
No, I don't think so. I hope he's just fine where he is. Like I said, don't worry about them.
Can you please put a call on her if she's laying on the bed?
That's why you got all of us to protect you.
Huh?
Folk like them. Now, how about that necklace you made? You still got it, right?
Yeah, I got it.
Good. Did you like fishing?
It was okay, I think. It's a lot of waiting around.
It is.
You boys getting on?
Great! We caught a fish, and I made you this necklace.
Ain't that pretty? Not the luckiest. Did you thank Uncle Arthur?
No need. We had a good time.
What's wrong?
Nothing. Just met some folk. I better go speak with Dutch.
Okay.
Hey, you did real fine, kid.
Thanks.
We got a problem.
What?
I just met some guys out near the river. A fella named, Milton, and, I don't remember the other fella's name. Ross. Milton and Ross.
And
they are employees of the Pinkerton Detective Agency. And they know about the train, and they know we're here.
Were you followed back here?
No. They know we're near here. And they want you, Dutch. They offered me my freedom in exchange, they did.
Why didn't you take it?
Very funny. Well, what do we do now?
I say we do nothing.
Okay, thanks.
Just yet. They're just trying to scare us. They're doing something stupid.
Good boy.
We have turned a corner. We survived them mountains. We just need to stay calm.